Hi, welcome back. My name is Dima Inyuki, and this will be my first vlog. Now this should have been the very first video on my YouTube, because to me this will probably be the most important video I will probably ever make, as far as it's important to me because it's about Resident Evil. Now, I haven't done much on my YouTube about Resident Evil, but it's quite literally the reason I got into gaming. It's the first series I fell in love with. And I mean, I can't remember the first game I've ever played. It was either an old Mario on the original Game Boy, or it was when we got our first PC and it came with Doom, Heretic, and Quake. But regardless, it is the first series I fell in love with, and I've been a fan of it since the very, very beginning. And as you can tell, I have a lot of stuff. Also, another reason I'm making this video is it is, what is it, January 10th. Yeah, January 10th, 2017. Right before the release of Resident Evil 7 and the new movie coming out, Resident Evil: The Final Chapter. You actually might see. This actually might be the last movie of the Resident Evil series, as far as the live action. But as far as the games, well, we never know until the future. But regardless, because of those two things coming out, and there's a lot of young gamers out there that probably haven't even played a single Resident Evil, and Resident Evil 7 is probably going to be their first game. I wanted to kind of make an all-knowing video. Basically, the only video you really ever need to see to know kind of the history and backstory of the Resident Evil series. So let's just start from the beginning. Resident Evil came out in 1996. That's when the first game dubbed. That game did a lot of things for the gaming community. One, it's the very first dubbed survivor horror game. It literally spawned tons of survivor horror after that. The biggest series being the Silent Hill series, which I think is the perfect counterpart to the Resident Evil series. Because Resident Evil is about, it's about your zombie apocalypse, but it's more about the characters and what they go through. And where Silent Hill does the alternate of that, not alternate, but it focuses on paranormal, but it still focuses on what the characters go through. Let's see. Since then, since 1996, there actually hasn't even been any years where there hasn't been a single Resident Evil game coming out. And that's 21 years. That's 21 years of Resident Evil. The years being that there's no games was 2008, 2010, 2013, and 2014. And I'm not sure about copyright, but I do believe you actually have to, like, if you have something claimed, you actually have to produce content for it. That's probably why. Why some of the games exist. I could be wrong. I'm not an expert on that. But it literally revolutionized the older games were like a fixed camera angle. And when Resident Evil 4 came out, it revolutionized third person shooters. But I'll get to that later. And it's really the driving point of horror games before that time. And you know, the people that make Resident Evil, Capcom, they have made so many good stuff. They made the Street Fighter series. They made the Mega Man series. They made the Monster Hunter series, which is actually doing pretty well right now. They've spawned some horror games after the fact. Did they do Evil? Oh, Bethesda did that. Okay. They did the Dead Rising series. I feel like that they made that series parallel to Resident Evil. Mostly because they kind of wanted to make a humorous, comical, you know, zombie series. But what else did they make? I'm probably going to forget. Oh, Devil May Cry. Devil May Cry series. That's been pretty big. But lately, as far as Resident Evil, I mean, Resident Evil 6 came out 2012. So it's been 5 years. 5 years since a good Resident Evil game's come out. What I mean by good is the main series. So I have a question to ask you all. Do you know how many Resident Evil games there are? So Resident Evil 7's coming out, so you probably assume it's 7? And that would be incorrect. Now, you might know about the core series, and you're like, all right, Resident Evil 0 exists. And then there was Code Veronica. So, 9? And you would also be incorrect. Now, regardless of ports, because there's been tons of ports to the Resident Evil series, in my opinion, there are, right now, Resident Evil 7 will be the 22nd Resident Evil game. Now, a lot of people might say, oh, arcade games count and all that stuff. Whatever. But there has been 22 Resident Evil games, which I actually have behind me on this. So I own every single Resident Evil game, and I own all the movies. And we will get to that in a second. Okay, let me go through all the Resident Evil games in order of release. So, in the very beginning, 1996, Resident Evil. Resident Evil. Okay. Resident Evil originally came out, I want to say the PS1? Like, it came out on the PS1. I just don't remember it was on a weird console before that. PS1. It got ported. Got ported to the Sega Saturn. And it was also on the Windows, and it had a pretty much direct port to the DS, but the DS had some extra features in it. Like, I do believe there is a mode where you literally go through with just a knife. After that, 1 year later, you got Resident Evil 2, also on the PS1, the 64, the Dreamcast, GameCube, PlayStation Network. I should probably be explaining. So Resident Evil 1. So I'm going to explain a little bit about what each game did. Resident Evil 1. Also, I group the Resident Evils in two categories. There is the old and then the new. The old ends, in my opinion, ends with Resident Evil File 2, or if you want to stick with the main series, Resident Evil 0, or if you want to stick with the timeline, the last Resident Evil in that series is 3. The first Resident Evil came out. It featured yourself in a haunted mansion, you know, with zombies. Your team called STARS. There's Special Tactics and Recon Service team that goes in, and basically there's been strange killings and stuff like that. And then the game goes from there. You can play two different campaigns. One, you play as Chris Redfield, and then the other one is Jill Valentine. It's actually, I do believe, the only games those two are in at the same time. Actually, I forgot about five. Yeah, they're mostly five. But anyway, going from that, and there was actually a director's cut in 1997. So in 1998 was Resident Evil 2. That featured two other characters. Now, the one was featured in a mansion, kind of on like a mountain. Resident Evil 2, you were in the city. The city of Raccoon City. And Raccoon City is literally the pivotal point of Resident Evil. It's where everything important happened. Not really important, but... They stuck to Raccoon City for quite a while. Resident Evil 2 featured also two different campaigns. One was Leon S. Kennedy, literally his first day on the force. He was kind of with the police. He wasn't a STARS member. He's actually with pretty much the Raccoon Police Department. And then the other character was. Claire Redfield, which was actually Chris's sister. She doesn't really have, as far as I know, she doesn't have any actually special training, but she definitely kicks butt in that game. Going from there, which is probably my favorite, if you have to ask me what my favorite Resident Evil is, I can't really tell you out of both, but out of the old series, Resident Evil 3 is my favorite. A lot of people like 2. 2 has a lot of good stuff going for it. It's got a great story. It's where you meet Ada, which is a lot of people's favorite character. In Resident Evil 1, you meet Wesker. And he's actually I don't know if I would call him a good guy in that one. But anyway, Resident Evil 3, you're still in the city. You play as Jill Valentine. It's her solo game. Literally, that's it. So I'm going to stop there and pretty much... So Resident Evil, every single game... So Resident Evil is about, you know, zombies and how the zombies came to be. A lot of people like lore of the zombies. Some, you know, it's just a virus, but it's actually a technical virus called the T-virus. The T actually stands for tyrant, which not a lot of people know. But every single Resident Evil game, at least in the core series, I do believe every game's canon, by the way, but... out of the core series, every single one features a new virus. So Resident Evil 1, you got T-Virus. Resident Evil 2, you got the G-Virus, created by Birkin. Resident Evil 3 is the Nemesis virus, which everyone knows Nemesis. He's literally the only boss you fight in Resident Evil 3. But you fight him like 10 times. It's pretty awesome. And something Resident Evil does a lot in like every single series is transformations. Besides the first game, I can't remember anything transforming. But you get multiple versions of the, like, the boss will transform and you fight like that version and transform again, fight that version. It's pretty great. I really like that the series did that. Anyway, going from Resident Evil 3, after that they did Survivor. Now, Survivor is their first off-series game. It has nothing to do with main characters. I do believe he has a little bit to do with Leon, from what I heard, because it's actually, I have actually not beaten that one. And they made 3. It's out of a series called the Gun series. There's 3 games in the Gun series. Resident Evil Survivor, Resident Evil Veronica, and Resident Evil Dead Aim. I don't believe the US versions did this, but at least the Japanese and European versions, you literally hooked up a gun to the TV and you shot with it, just like a Wii remote. Which was actually pretty cool. They did, so basically you press a button, you're in the crosshairs, and you can shoot anything on the screen. So they really, I mean, every single Resident Evil, they pushed themselves to do more intuitive things and just kept going, you know, not just making the same. The Resident Evils, the one thing they don't do is make the same game just, you know, more story stuff. So, but, so Resident Evil Survivor, that was for the PS1. Then they did Code Veronica. Code Veronica is actually part of the core series. It kind of is a really important one from Wesker. If you know who Wesker is, I don't know who doesn't know who Wesker is, but it's an important one for him. You also track down the kids of one of the founders of Umbrella. Let me look it up, make sure I'm telling you right.
Wait, don't shoot! Who are you? Huh? You're not a zombie? Well, great! Wait right there!
Founders of Umbrella. Lord, I like him. Oswald E. Spencer, Sir Edward Ashford, and James Marcus. Every single one of those die. Actually, let me look up Sir Edward. If I remember correctly, Sir Edward funded. He basically funded the entire thing. Okay, that's what I thought. So Spencer actually backstabs Edward and ends up to being his demise. James Marcus gets killed by Wesker and Resident Evil before Resident Evil 5, and Spencer dies in 0, I do believe. Yeah, because I think Birkin and Wesker kill Spencer. Basically, Wesker just fucks over everyone. quite literally everyone. Anyway, so Code Veronica features Claire Redfield. It's her solo game. Pretty much makes her a badass. It's really important, and they really copied a lot of things in the Resident Evil movies. With Alice in the Resident Evil Apocalypse movie, they literally, like, her, in that movie, she's running, some helicopters are shooting through glass, and she's running from it. That comes straight from Veronica. There's a part to where she's literally hands up, some Umbrella officers are holding guns to her, and she drops the gun, but then she falls down and shoots them all. That's also Claire's move. They took a lot from that, and you gotta think about the Resident Evil movie series, the live action, as a separate. It's literally has nothing to do with Resident Evil. They're just conning off the franchise, because the character Alice doesn't exist in the movie. Right now, Wesker's like a pseudo good guy, I guess. I don't know. I'll go over those later. But that was Code Veronica. Then they. Then in 2002, he actually had two games that came out. the remake of Resident Evil, which, in my opinion, like, older games are good. I love older games, you know, the original. That's why the first one is so, like, Capcom just worships the first game, because it literally just changed the whole gaming community. But it did need a remake. A lot of bad rep comes from the first game, and that is due to the... At the time of me playing it, I really didn't notice. I was like, okay, it's an older game, but it's got some pretty questionable lines. Being the famous is the Jill Sandwich line right before she gets crushed by one of those rooms where the ceiling's coming down. She almost gets crushed, and another STARS operative, his name's Barry Burton. He pretty much says, "Oh, you almost became a Jill Sandwich."
Oh, Barry!
That was too close. You were almost a Jill Sandwich.
You're right.
And that's been made fun of. There's literally a shop in Dead Rising 1 called Jill Sandwiches, and it's been just kind of a laughing thing. But definitely need a remake. It quite literally changes nothing from the original, besides the graphics. They completely reworked the graphics. Like, literally, it's a completely different game. They literally reworked the graphics. Yeah, they reworked the graphics. They did different camera angles. I mean, you got some interesting camera angles. I love the camera angles in that one where it's like under a desk, or it's just in some really creepy spots, and I love it. Combat's, you know, a little bit smoother. Oh, the combat. So, actually, I'll get to that once I cover all the Resident Evils. So, they improved the combat. There are sections in the game where you could beat it in like 10 minutes, and they literally expanded it in, like, it would take you an hour, hour and a half to beat that part. That's how much they expanded on some of the areas in the game. But it's literally the same game. Like, if you don't play the old one, at least play the remake. It's worth a play. And they've done multiple ports. I mean, they have a 3 Xbox One PS4 port right now. I don't know if it's on PC, but so anyway, after that, Resident Evil Zero. Now, Resident Evil Zero it's not my favorite out of the old series, but I've definitely played it the most out of the old ones, because it's got a really good, you literally can control two characters at once. It features Rebecca Chambers. Now, think about the STARS has two groups. They have Alpha and Delta, I think. It's either Delta or Beta or something like that. But they have two groups. Literally everyone... Actually, they really haven't confirmed if currently Rebecca's alive, but her name's Rebecca Chambers, and she's the only survivor out of the Delta team. And ironically, she's the medic. I guess she knows how to keep herself alive. And then out of the Alpha team, you got, like, yeah, Chris, Barry's still alive. I actually think that's it.
I thought they were dead.
Because Leon is part of the... Oh, Jill. Jill's part of it. Leon, Chris, Jill. That actually might be it. Because Claire's not part of it. But anyway, so Resident Evil Zero is a really good one. It's still the old school style, but it's got this character swap mechanic where you get like one key with one character, You pass it up through an elevator, you switch to that other character, grab that key, and then you can unlock the door to the other character that they're stuck in, and it's such a well-made game for what it is. And so, and then you always have that partner with you that's also helping you shoot, and you're managing their inventories and stuff like a good survival horror does. One thing about the first Resident Evil is there's literally the reason that game's so hard is literally there is not a bullet for every zombie. You literally have to keep some alive and run away. Unless you're good enough at killing everything with a knife, which I'm not. I've seen the knife only runs and they're crazy, but anyway, so that's Zero. Zero is really good. It focuses on the progenitor virus, which was carried through leech DNA. So it's got a lot of leeches in that one, which is kind of interesting. But the progenitor virus led up to the infamous T virus. And then going from there, they made quite a few spin-off games. They made the Dead Aim game, which was the second in the Gun Survivor. That one, you're on a boat. Just literally on a boat the entire time. And that one's interesting. That one still has some iconic Resident Evil enemies. So other than the zombies, you have crows, you have the zombie dogs, then you have two of the really famous kind of creations. You have the Lickers, which, if you haven't seen the movie series, the Lickers, according to the movie series, they are derived from bunnies. They're literally bunnies for some reason. I don't know if that's canon to the game, but they crawl on all fours, they have an exposed brain, they're blind, so I guess they go by scent or hearing, and they have an outrageously long tongue, which might as well be a giant tentacle. But this tongue they use to attack, to wrap their victims up around the neck and stuff, choke them. That's literally how they attack. In Resident Evil 5, they made them a little beefier, so they can attack you with claws. But that's almost the purpose of the second one, which is called a hunter. And it's literally kind of a lizard. I wouldn't say it's a frog, but really doesn't look like any kind of lizard. So it's kind of built like a frog, but more lizard. Because it's got like the scales and stuff. And that little suckers, man, they literally just attack with claws, and they're usually the most powerful enemies. Like in game of Resident Evil 1, then hunters start spawning all the place, and they literally can take your head off in one hit. Hunters are in Dead Aim, and then they made two interesting series games. Now these ones are so fun, but they were multiplayer. Support up to four people, they were multiplayer. Currently right now, the servers, they actually took the server down. I guess in Japan there's private servers you can make. You might be able to figure out how to make private servers, but it was interesting because it's still controls are still like the old school Resident Evils, which the controls, in my opinion, survival horror, the less control you, a lot of people hate it, but the less control, like I can talk about horror in itself, the less control you give an individual, the scarier the game will be. If you go through a game where you don't have a weapon, or maybe you take away the control of light, so you don't have control of your light, like you don't have a flashlight and it's really dark, or just stuff like that. Maybe you're literally strapped to a chair and all you can do is look around. That's taking control away from the individual. And in my opinion, other than like build up atmosphere and tension and stuff like that, I really think it makes, that's why the Resident Evil, the older games are scary, because you take away the control, like, you can't, I can move, like, I played them long enough where I feel comfortable moving them, but they're literally in a tank, they're called tank controls. So, you turn your character, left or right, and then you can go forward. You can also go backwards. Now, a lot of the newer, older games, like Resident Evil 0 and the remake of 1, you can tilt the controller so you can still walk, you can still turn while you're walking forward, but it's a lot different from, like, playing a Mario game where you press, you know, you're above them, you press down or up and stuff, and that's the direction he goes. I really think that leads to the Resident Evil's original ones being so scary, because you'd be going down a hallway and all of a sudden, like, you have dogs or zombies burst through a window, and at that point it's either fight or flight, and it really did make them scarier. And I really appreciate those controller games. You really don't see those kind of games anymore. There are a lot of indie games will do that kind of controls, but they don't really have that anymore. Kind of. So I'll get to that later, but the Outbreak games, they still were the old school style games, so you had your inventory space, you had your health that you have to do, you have your limited ammo. No ammo was ever just unlimited in any Resident Evil game. In a lot of games you can unlock unlimited ammo, but in most games you can't. But the Outbreak series, they had some great levels. I mean, the last level in the first one literally took you an hour and a half to 2 hours, even up to 3 hours to beat that level sometimes. That was the great, well-designed levels. And they got, in the game, they also have, like, random, kind of random generated events and stuff. So depending on circumstances, you actually had to take the level differently. And you could play out of 8 different characters, and they all played a little bit differently. So, I really love those games. If you haven't played those games, pick them up. You can still play it single player. You're going to be spawned in with, I don't remember if there's 4 or 3. There's either 4 or 3of you in a game at once. But yeah, there are computers, and I mean, the computers are kind of idiots, but they do their job. But that's a really great series. So they made an Resident Evil Outbreak and Resident Evil Outbreak 5 too. So they made 2 of those. And then that would be the end of the old games. So all of those games I would consider I believe them as the old games. And then you got probably the most important game other than the first game to come out, and that would be Resident Evil 4. Now, out of the new games, my favorite's 5. The reason I wouldn't put 4 there is because as a game, it's a fantastic game. I mean, multiple things say that's literally the perfect game. And when that came out on the GameCube, it again, since the first game, it re-evolutionized the gaming series. After that came out, so many third-person shooters. I mean, you got, like, the Mass Effects, you got the Gears of War, you got all these games. It really pushed the third-person perspective. However, still, tank controls, when you look at it, you're just at a different perspective. Because you press forward to go forward, you turn your character, and then you can go back if you wanted to. Also, a lot of the Resident Evil games, if you press down and whatever, either A or I think A or X, your character spins. Welcome. And goes the opposite direction, which was really needed in those games. But Resident Evil 4 literally defined the entire franchise. After they, spoiler, if you didn't know, after they nuke, Raccoon City to destroy, actually, Umbrella did that. They nuked, Raccoon City to destroy any evidence of their pretty much fuck-up. That was, you know, going to be the end. Resident 4 takes you in control of Leon again, and he goes on his adventure in Europe. I want to say it's Spain, but I'm probably wrong on that. No, I'm pretty sure it's Spain. But yeah, he goes to Europe and discovers, you know, there's a new threat, kind of. He encounters these things called the Lost Plagas. Now, if you've seen the Resident Evil movies, they literally don't explain this, but when you have, like, the mouth mandibles come out of the zombies, those are the Lost Plagas. And Lost Plagas is not a virus, it's a parasite. So I guess in that game, they dug up these parasites, and what they do is they inject people with them, and they attach themselves to the spinal cord, and then after a while they become, I guess, infected. The leader of those is the new bad guy. His name's Osmond Sadler. It kind of works as the hive mind thing, where he controls all Lost Plagas. He's obviously, when you meet him, he's obviously infected, but or he's obviously, you know, not exactly human, but he literally controls all Lost Plagas. So it does the beehive kind of thing, where you have your queen bee, and then you have all, like, your little slaves. So that's kind of where that game took a turn. So Lost Plagas is, as far as I know, still in the series, because I do believe it's awesome 5 and 6. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. But in 6, they kind of tie in T-Virus with Lost Plagas. So you kind of got both of the spectrum. Now, a lot of, like, hardcore Resident Evil fans didn't like 4 at first, because it was like, what the heck? Where's the T-Virus? Where's all this stuff? It's completely different. You had zombies, you know, like, throwing axes at you, and, you know, actually doing formations and stuff. And I really think Capcom wanted to make not the dumb zombie, but kind of make a good horror, survival horror shooter, and take a different take to it. And I really enjoyed it. I didn't hate it at all. But anyway, so that was Resident Evil 4. That came out in 2005, which was 10, 11, 12 years ago. That is quite a while. Then you had Resident Evil Deadly Silence, which I do believe was the DS release of the first game. That is the technical port, but they dubbed it Deadly Silence, and I think it's basically the same game, but there's, like, different modes, and they might have simplified it a lot more to work on the DS. But that was the first handheld Resident Evil game, and there's many handhelds after that. So that was 2006. 2007 was the Umbrella Chronicles. Now, that came out on the Wii. Only on the Wii. Umbrella Chronicles, there's two of those games. There's Umbrella Chronicles and then the Dark Side Chronicles. They made those games because at that point, you know, Resident Evil's been out 11 years. So they kind of want to catch a lot of people up on the story and lore and everything. Honestly, you can pick any Resident Evil game up, play it, be fine with it. You really don't have to ever play any game in its chronological timeline. Unless, I mean, other than avoiding spoilers that you would have not known about if you were planning on playing the other games. But Umbrella Chronicles was for the Wii. It was a rail shooter. Rail shooter kind of arcade style. So you use the Wii controllers, you shot the screen. Rail shooters, if you're not familiar with rail shooters, they put your character on a path that you can't change off of. I do believe you can choose like choices where you want, left or right, but literally on a path, you don't control movement. I think in those games, no, I don't even think you control where you look, but you don't control movement. You literally just shoot. It's just like if you went to the arcade. But those games, they caught people up because they, out of the Umbrella Chronicles and Darkseid Chronicles, they basically went through all the core series games, took the entire game, usually spanned it out of three chapters, and you basically got the gist that went down for those games. So if you don't want to play all the Resident Evil games, those are really good ones to pick up. They're fun to play, you can play with two people, and yeah, you know, get the gist of the story. So that one came out in 2007, 2008, there was no Resident Evil. 2009 came out Resident Evil 5. Now that was 4 years after Resident Evil 4. Resident Evil 4 came out 5 years after Veronica, which those are all core series games. So there's quite a span of several years without a core series. So every time a big core series like 7's going to come out, it's pretty big. It's pretty, you know, it's a pretty good thing. Resident Evil 5, you took place as Chris again. This time he's a little bit buffer. So in the main series, you know, he's your strong, broad shoulder kind of guy. In 5, he is just a tank. He is like built. He has huge ass arms. The community kind of like made fun of it a lot, but I thought it was an interesting take on his character, because I felt like him and Leon really didn't have that much difference between each other, but now they kind of, you know, they made him look different. So he's like that built rock kind of guy, and Leon is more of the, you know, 007, go in, roll around, wreck shoes. But Resident Evil 5, takes place in Africa, which it got a lot of flack on that one, because, you know, shooting black people. But I mean, the zombies, it's kind of funny, because it got a lot of crap for that, but, sorry, African Americans. But they mixed in, you fought Mexicans, and you fought, Asians. And all of those were mixed in with the zombies, so I love how that got a lot of flack. But that takes place in Africa, and you are Chris Redfield, and you actually have a partner in that one. Her name's Sheva. And again, you're doing some more, you know, finding out kind of the backstory in the Resident Evil stuff. Not really backstory, but there's, with the newer games, when 4 and on, it basically takes a terrorist approach, where they have like a main bad guy that basically has a virus or a parasite or something like that, and they're gonna basically attack a big country or something. So 4 had the Las Plagas, 5. You actually, you're fighting Wesker. You meet Wesker secondhand, which you never really see Wesker working with anybody besides Birkin. I can't remember her name off the top of my head. But then you have her, and you have a few other guys that you take down in that one. But that one, it kind of completes the whole series, because you actually find out about the progenitor virus that they actually derived from a plant in Africa. So literally the entire T virus, you can go back and they derived that from a plant in Africa. Combine that with leech DNA, you got the progenitor virus, or the T virus, I don't remember which one. So that's Resident Evil 5. And then in 2009, they released the Dark Side Chronicles, which, in Resident Evil 4, you meet a character that apparently knows Leon. His name is Krauser. They kind of explain his existence in Dark Side Chronicles, because Krauser, you know, he knows Leon at this point, and everyone's going, who the heck is this guy? They explain, his story, and then in Dark Side Chronicles, they also cover Code Veronica, Resident Evil, and Resident Evil 2. There's Umbrella Chronicles that covers 0, 1, and 3, and in Dark Side Chronicles it covers 2 and Code Veronica. So Umbrella Chronicles comes out in 2007, and you play as multiple protagonists in both those games. And again, those are on the Wii. In 2008, there was nothing, and then... Actually, I'm gonna stop there. So Resident Evil 4 originally came out for the GameCube. Resident Evil 4 is literally on everything now. So I have quite a few right here. But, so the GameCube version, see that right there? Only for GameCube? Well, they released it. They released a new version for the PS2. That had a separate Ada campaign, more weapons, but they took out a lot of the destructibles in the game. So like where you could shoot a light before, now you can't shoot the light, which I thought was kind of lame, because that game has crazy replay value. Then they made a Wii version, which you could use the Wii remote to shoot and stuff like that, but... I don't think I've actually beaten that one, but it's interesting, but I still don't think, I don't know, I like the control aiming with that one. And then they've done new reports, they've done the 360, what's it called, remaster, where they improve the graphics on the 360, and it runs a little bit smoother. And then they did the ports, so you got your Xbox One, PS4 ports. So four is literally on everything. They also have, apparently they have it on the cell phone, so you literally can play cell phone ones. So on the Androids and iPhones you can play. And they also have it up for the computer, which they've done multiple mods and stuff. Those kind of get funny. And then, after the Dark Side Chronicles, 2010, there was nothing. Then they made their second portable game, which was Mercenaries Versus. Just Mercenaries Versus? Yeah. Mercenaries Versus. Now, in Resident Evil 4, 5, and 6, there is a kind of a mini game where it's kind of like a time attack mode. You're putting a... Put in a small arena, you go through, kill as many guys, you have limited ammo, but guys drop ammo in. Well, that's another thing, enemies drop ammo in 4. I can't remember any game before that did that. I want to say Dead Aim, maybe, but other than that, no other. You kill zombies in Resident Evil 1, that's it. You find your ammo in the level, you don't find them off zombies. Where 4, 5, and 6 definitely, like, that's where you get most of your inventory. But anyway, so you fight enemies in a kind of a little small arena. It's a well-designed level arena. Like there's areas to it. And then if you finish off enemies in with a melee, you get extra time. And there actually is, I think it's like 150. Actually, I think Resident Evil 4, there's they're limited till your time runs out in Resident 5 and 6. You literally, if you destroy like 100, it's either 120 or 150, I can't remember. Once you kill them all, then the time ends, and any time you have left over is left, you know, it's whatever, and then you get a score. Those are actually really fun. It's a really fun game mode. They literally made a 3DS game called Mercenaries Versus, and that's all that game is. That it's literally that bonus mode. It incorporates aspects from 4, or characters and aspects from 4 and 5. They put in Claire, which isn't in any of them, and they put her in it. You have multiple costumes. It's really fun game. They did it. It feels really good. At times you get lag, but it's, you know, it's on the 3DS. It, for what it is, it's really great on that 3DS. Mercenaries Versus. Oh, so Mercenaries Versus is the cell phone version. I was wondering why it sounded weird. So Mercenaries Versus is a cell phone version. Mercenaries 3D is the Mercenaries 3D is the 3DS version. So that was really good. So that game doesn't have its own story at all. It's literally just basically a mini game in itself. And then they did the Revelations. Revelations they did on the 3DS first, and it actually was well received. You play as Jill Valentine again for the first time since 3, Resident Evil 3, which was other than the little parts you play in Resident Evil 5, it's literally the first time you play as Jill, and that's 13 years span till she gets her own game again. So that came out on the 3DS, and it was such a good game for a handheld. And I'm actually surprised there's no Vita. The PlayStation Vita, because that console's really really powerful, where they decided to put it on the 3DS, but 3DS, a lot more people had the 3DS, so it's probably why they did that. And it's kind of interesting how there's so many Resident Evil games for the Nintendo, being a mature title. So Revelations came out on that, and then later on they actually made I want to say it's a year after they made the console port. Yeah, so a year after they made the console ports, it improved the graphics, but it was exactly the same game. And again, really great story in that one. I think it takes place between 5 and 6. It's either in between 5 and 6 or in between 4 and 5. Actually, I want to say it's in between 4 and 5, chronologically. And again, it's such a great game, and they did a different take on the almost Mercenaries type mini game, where you go through the same levels, but you have different challenges, or I don't think it's different challenges, but you go through and you kill more powerful monsters, you level up, you almost get like random guns in that, where they have different specs and stuff like that, and they get more powerful, and you actually level up your character, which was interesting. So that took a very interesting turn. And then in the same year, 2012, Operation Raccoon City came out. Now they revisited Raccoon City, which was kind of an interesting game. But this time you play as Umbrella operatives. Another operative group in Umbrella. They have like so many, but there's an important event that takes place in 2, and if I didn't give spoilers, well, spoiler alert, they take out Birkin, which develops a G-Virus. Resident Evil was claiming their basically property, and they send in a team. The team is led by Hunk. He's literally the most badass out of badasses. And So this group goes in, they're kind of led by him, but then he kind of breaks off with them, so they're their own group. But he eventually gets the virus, but it's kind of their take through all the Resident Evils. Like, so they're kind of in the background, not to all of Resident Evils, they're in the background from the first game to the second to the third, and you actually get to fight Birkin and Nemesis in that game. And at the end, you can actually, it's the what if thing where you actually can decide whether to kill the main protagonist in two or not. So that was kind of an interesting take, and that did the. It did the third person, but it did it very well in an almost shooter aspect, like a Call of Duty type shooter. But I don't know, they did it really well. And that game was also very interesting, where you're almost fighting three sides. There's three sides, well, not fighting three sides, there's three sides that's fighting at almost at all times. You have the zombies, you have the umbrella like police station, their whole group, and then you have yourself. So there's almost you're a lot of times you're fighting either like the police department or like this other umbrella group while dealing with zombies. So it was really interesting. And they start to develop in that game, they start to develop, even though it's in the old games, they develop Lee's jammer type things where it sends off a signal where the zombies aren't attacking you. To a point, but yeah, that was a really, it was a really interesting take, and I freaking loved it. And yeah, it has an online player mode, and as far as I know, it's still up. Where there's like you can play as a heroes and stuff like that. And I don't know, it's that one's a really good game. And then in the same year, Resident Evil 6 came out. That was a good year, apparently. Resident Evil 6 got so much, I feel like it got so much hate. It's like, oh man, Resident Evil 6 did horrible, blah blah. It's like, and usually when those people say that, I'm like, did you even play the game? No. Okay. In my opinion, Resident Evil 6 was literally the most action-packed, ridiculous game out of the Resident Evil series yet. It was intense. Like, I literally was on the edge of my seat the entire time. Like, it's almost to a point where there's literally no downtime. There's literally no downtime where recuperate yourself, manage your inventory, find out what you need, you know, all that stuff. You're literally just running and gunning that entire game. And that entire game has four different campaigns. You have campaign where you go through as Leon and Leon and Helena. And each campaign, I really liked what they did. They made it a different style of game almost. Even though you had the same controls. So with Leon and Helena, it took the original survival horror kind of approach to it. At least in the beginning, where you're going through the city, you know, there's zombies, it's kind of chill, you end up in a bar, and it's really, I really like that one. Yeah, in the first part, you're out of school, so it's, or actually university. So there's that one. Then you play through as Chris and Piers. You play as Chris and Piers, and that's more of the military. Like, you're always with like a group, like a squad. So it kind of takes that like Call of Duty style to it. And so his is interesting because he pretty much is a military guy. And then you go through as Jake and Sherry, and Jake is basically Resident Evil's version of Dante, because he almost says that like he moves really fast, and he's always like pinpoint accuracy and just taking down guys. Basically, he's just invincible at that point. And Sherry, she's in Resident Evil 2. She's kind of like a person you find. She's actually Birkin's daughter, if I remember correctly. But she, because of Birkin's experiment, she, like, I guess she's invincible. Like, she has, like, really good regeneration and stuff. So basically, that campaign, they're just basically, you know, all powerful, almost. But you're on, like, in that one, you're on, like, car chases and jet skis. And that one's, that one's just probably my favorite out of the four campaigns. And then the fourth one is, other than Resident Evil 4, it's the first time you actually play Ada Wong, and she's going through, and you're doing a story with her. And hers is more like Splinter Cell stealthiness, where you're taking out zombies at that point. And in Resident Evil 6, they introduced the C virus, which is a chrysalis virus. So I guess it's more bug type. So you got, depending on where you shoot enemies, they spawn like wings or like grasshopper legs, or they like literally like have like cocoon shells which you can't shoot, and you have to shoot other parts of their body. So that one's it's really good. Like, by no means is it horrible. And so it still has that, they improved on the gameplay so much, where you can literally like jump back, shoot, do like quick shots. Just tons of, like, that, it's so fluid, it's almost too fluid, controls, and it's really fun. That's a really fun game. That's actually the first game where I've actually legitimately ran out of ammo. I ran out of ammo on a boss, and I was like, what the do you do now? But anyway, when Resident Evil 6 came out, I guess they just put all their games out that year, so there's actually not another game for the next 2 years. And then they made a second part to the Revelation series, which was kind of out of nowhere to me, because I was like, it was a good game, but I didn't feel like it was that good of a game, I guess. But they made a second Revelations game, and that one it's kind of in a certain style, where you basically get kidnapped and you're on an island, and you play as Claire and Barry Burton's daughter. Gina. Oh, actually, I forgot about that. So you play as Claire and Moria? I don't remember her name being Moria. Yeah, Moria. So you play as it does the alternate campaign. So you're playing through the story and you're switching between the two characters. You play as Claire and Moria, and this is a two-player game. You play as Claire and Moria, and then you switch to Birkin, the first time you play as him, and a little girl named Natalia. And I've been told, I actually haven't played The Last of Us, but I've been told it takes a lot of things from that series. I actually haven't finished that one. So I haven't finished Survivor, Code Veronica, Outbreak File 2, or Revelations 2, but I plan on doing that. I probably will restart it and just do a Let's Play of it. And then in 2016, I actually did played it and recorded it on my YouTube, but they came out with the Umbrella Corps. That had no physical release, and they really did not commercialize it at all. The release of that game almost took me a surprise. and it almost its existence. I really don't know why they made that game. But it's a tactical shooter, and if you want to check it out, it's on my YouTube. But yeah, it's just this weird tactical shooter, and it's got like, I feel like it's got a good multiplayer going for it, but again, it's just questionable of his existence. I don't know why they felt like, because I feel like every Resident Evil has a point as a reason it's out, or it did something new to the series. Where that one, it definitely feels different, like a lot different, but it almost feels like Operation Raccoon City, but it's interesting. I mean, I don't believe it's that much right now. But yeah, that is the last Resident Evil game to come out since till Resident Evil 7 comes out, which that comes out 16 days. So 16 days Resident Evil 7 comes out. So that, and then they are working on the remake of Resident Evil 2, which I do believe the series needs, especially being the cult's favorite, like basically that game that everyone feels like is the best Resident Evil game, even though my favorite is 3 and 5. So that is the Resident Evil series, and I've been rambling for quite a while. But there is a lot of games. It's been this whole experience. I mean, I've played it since the beginning. It's literally defined me, as far as a gamer and stuff, because I always go back to them. I'm always playing them, going back to them, playing them again, playing the re-releases and stuff like that. But that's the game series. That's literally every single game. You can put in the comments below if there's another game, but I'm pretty sure there's not, unless there's some weird arcade type thing, but that, it's really not going to be that important. But along with the games, they made 5 live action movies. I have actually mentioned them a lot. But I'm just going to briefly go through those. Now, I actually have the Blu-ray and DVD of all of them, but the Blu-rays I don't have on my person right now. So, this is 2002. Resident Evil came out. Now, this is a dated movie, because this came out 14 years ago, which is quite a while, and this is the only one I would call a horror movie. The other ones are all action-y. The things they take from this that are also in the game, the place called the Hive is not an umbrella facility in the games, it's a hospital. You have zombies, the T-virus, they show liquors in the movie. None of the main characters are in the movie. So, they also have zombie dogs. I don't think they have crows in that one yet. But that's literally it. Oh, they also have Umbrella. But that's literally, I don't think the Red Queen has any importance in the games. I can't remember. If it is, it's very small, minute, but that, so Mila Jovovich actually is in every single movie. She's the main protagonist. She is a character named Alice, and in the first movie you find out she is works for Umbrella. She's basically a security operative, but after this one, she gets experimented on, and she's basically a pretty much superhuman. The second movie in the live-action movie series is Resident Evil Apocalypse. Resident Evil Apocalypse, to me, is the one that feels like the games the most. So if all you've seen is the movies, it's going to be, it's the most closest feels to the games. And then the things from the games they bring in on this one is, quite literally, Nemesis is in it. They have Jill Valentine, even though she's not as badass as she is in the game, because Alice kind of fills that role. She even makes a comment as like, I'm good, but not that good. And she's actually that good, but not in the movie series, apparently. And I think that's it. Yeah, I don't think they have any other characters. And apparently in this one, Nemesis is originally a human that gets infected by the G... I want to say G-virus, but it's probably a T-virus. And they do experiments on him, and they just basically wake up in a hospital. But that is everything that is from the games in that one. Then they have Resident Evil Extinction. Probably, my opinion, the worst one out of the five. It's got some interesting stuff, but I felt like they didn't know where to take it, so they just kind of made a movie. I don't know. But this one, so they introduced Wesker in this, and he's kind of, instead of, he's kind of in charge, but he's kind of like the head of this weird umbrella council that apparently is in every single country. But so introduce Wesker, then you have Birkin. They introduced Birkin in the other ones, but only briefly, where this one he's actually a character and he does things and he injects himself, and I think it's Birkin. If it's not, it's basically the same premise. He's basically obsessed with his research. Eventually they're going to take his research away, and he injects himself, and yeah, basically leads to his downfall. They also introduce Claire Redfield. Claire Redfield is in this one. And other than that, that is everything from the games in that movie. Then you have Resident Evil Afterlife, which is probably my favorite out of the five, just because they have a lot of shenanigans, but they also add a lot of the game stuff to it. Now, Resident Evil Afterlife, I really felt like they played Resident Evil 5 before they made this movie, because they have the Las Plagas, which they never explain in the movie. Just all of a sudden, zombies have freaking face mandibles. They bring in the Axeman, which I felt like the Resident Evil series put that in their games to counter Pyramid Head in the Silent Hill series. That's just me. So they literally had the exact character, the Axeman, or Executioner from Resident Evil 5. They have the same zombie dogs, where now they split apart from the middle, and so you have two halves of a dog, they're connected on the back, and you have all like the tentacle and teeth stuff going on. That's exactly like they are in 5. In the game, it's Chris and Sheva fighting Wesker. Instead of throwing him off a balcony thing, like he does in 5, he throws him into two little capsules. So that was interesting that they literally took that fight hand by hand. Probably enjoyed that fight in the movie in the game and put it in the movie. But literally, like, it just feels like they played Resident Evil 5 and they're like, oh my gosh, Resident Evil series is great, even though we've been making 4 freaking movies of it. But, because I really don't think they know I played the Resident Evil series. They might have played the first one in 5, but whatever. So that is everything from that one. And then the last movie to come out before this new one is Retribution, which I have this huge display of. Crap, let me put this back up. So, Retribution. And this one is kind of the kind of fuck all, like, let's just make it even crazier. the very beginning was promising. So, they could have, I want to say, saved the movie series, because the movie series is ridiculous, but it barely touches on what the games are about. But so in after Rising Apocalypse and on, basically Alice is like infected. Oh, by the way, if you're watching this and you haven't seen the movies, stop, watch the movies, and then watch this, because there's tons of spoilers in this. But Resident Retribution, it literally does the everything that's happened is a dream thing. So they're on the, you know, it ends in Afterlife where they're on the boat. The secret is Jill Valentine is now an umbrella person because she's infected with that little spider thing. Not infected, but she has a little like controlly mind control spider thing. But they're all coming on these ships, all these ships they're on a boat, and it's like, how the heck do you get out of that situation? And yet Alice just wakes up and literally the world is just apocalyptic. Characters that's died in the series are brought back. Wesker's almost a good guy. Almost. And I've only actually seen this movie once, and it was just ridiculous. Because you had the crazy... So in Resident Evil 4, 5, and 6, you literally have like army zombies. Where they're like wielding freaking rocket launchers and controlling vehicles and stuff, and they got that this and this. You literally have Nazi zombies in this, and it's an interesting one at most. And what's her face? Michelle Rodriguez comes back since the first movie, which is interesting. But they put in Ada Wong, which is played by a Asian, and the character in the games is not really Asian. She's kind of pretty much that
Simons.
She's pretty much that American, no, but almost like Japanese. It's hard to explain, but she's basically American in the games, and she's played by an Asian in the movie, which is kind of interesting. And even they say in the game, like, even though her name's Ada Wong, we don't even know if that's her actual name, even at right now, after she's been in the series for quite a while. So they put in Ada Wong, and they put in Barry Burton, and they put in Leon. And it is, I think those characters are so rough. They don't feel like they do in the games. Maybe I'm being too critical about it, but Leon is probably by far the worst character. It's rough. But it's, again, it's full of your action and stuff like that. And it leaves off at a pretty... They're literally at the White House. And Wesker's just sitting there in the presidential chair. And it brings a smile on my face. But it's such a... It's a movie. But... And they introduce... So, in the Resident Evil 4... No, they can't do that in 4. I think in 5 and 6, or just 5, Las Plagas can actually detach themselves from the host, and they literally fly around. They actually have those in this one in the end. So, that's as far as the live actions go. In the new movie coming up, the Resident Evil Final Chapter, from what they're advertising, I've been avoiding everything Resident Evil, everything, you know, the movie and the game. But as far as I know, what they're basically commercializing it in is, obviously it's a final chapter, most people like hopefully, but I was like, they can make these movies as long as they want, but they're going back to the original place in the first movie, which is the Hive. So that's super hype. So that's as far as the live action movies. Now I keep saying live action because they have actually made, they right now they've made not just two, a lot of people will be like two, but a lot of people know about the third animated movie. Now the anime movies are made by Capcom. And well, actually they might not be. But the, you know, Capcom makes sure they're done right. But they follow the game's lore to a T. If you want to watch some movies that represent the games and you don't want to play the games, they're really great ones. The first one being Resident Evil Degeneration features Leon and Claire, and they're at an airport for the beginning of the movie. So there's an outbreak in the airport. I'm thinking that gets quarantined, and yeah, it's got some good stuff. This was a good, this came out before the fifth movie, or fifth game, and it has some stuff that you don't need to know, but it's kind of interesting to know going into the fifth game. And so the biggest difference between the movies and the games is when there's an outbreak in the games, they always contain it. So, you know, the old games, they there's an outbreak in the city. The city is pretty much overrun, but literally the entire city gets quarantined and they nuke it. And then, you know, Las Plagas gets taken care of, because once you kill a host, then everything else becomes useless, I think. But yeah, everything. Resident Evil 6, I do not know how they quarantined that, because basically China's gone, and you got like you got infected America, and I think you got a few other places. Like, I don't know how that got quarantined, but basically in the games, literally everything gets quarantined, taken care of, and there's not a worldwide apocalyptic outbreak. Where in the movies, literally the world's gone. It's Walking Dead, basically. And, you know, everything's gone. And in an extinction, it makes a point to where the wildlife, everything takes a toll. And it's just gone. So that's the biggest difference between the games and movies. And then you have Resident Evil Damnation, which takes place right before 6. That features Leon again. And if you want to see Leon kick some butt, watch these two animated movies. And they also feature Ada. So you get she's got a good fight scene in that one. And it's a really good take on kind of the war. There, I guess there's this war going on between just like the government and these people that can actually control the C-virus, which they're literally injecting people with the C-virus and using them as, you know, military. So those are the two physical released animated movies. They've had one other one, which is called Resident Evil 4D Executioner. It is Squad and kind of their little story. I think they're mentioned in the books, and there's tons of Resident Evil books. But there's that. That is a movie. It does exist, and they're actually working on a fourth animated movie coming out in 2017. I don't know when, but that is going to be called Resident Evil Vendetta, and it looks like that one features Chris. And it says it's going to have Leon and Rebecca in it. So I'm excited for that one. Yeah. So I guess these are considered 3D animated horror films. So that is just the games, the movies, and stuff like that. But the Resident Evil, has done a lot more since then, and everything. Every game series has their merch. So let's just hit the merch. Resident Evil has had a lot of merchandise. Other than like shirts made by third-party companies, you got soundtracks, but I mean you got the weirdest merchandise ever, and I have some of it. And I mean I've done everything. I've done Resident Evil cosplays. I have quite a few of the figures. Now they have a huge figure line, which going into it, when I first found out there were so many of these figures, I was just blown away. But I mean, I want to show you this first. So they have, I have a lot of merchandise. I have a Resident Evil umbrella, which is pretty cool. I have my fandom. I literally, that's my pillow. Freaking Resident Evil pillow. Another umbrella pillow. And then they even have like some energy drinks, some Resident Evil T virus energy drinks. I've gotten a few of those. And like the merchandise is just huge. And they've had several special release like consoles. Like the Dreamcast had actually a Claire console and a Stars console. I think not Resident Evil, I think PS3 had their Resident Evil version console. There was a Resident Evil GameCube that came out. There's been Chainsaw GameCube controllers. I have both the Wii. So there's this thing called the Wii Zapper. You put both the controllers in like a little gun. So I have the Magnum and knife in that one. And then I have one that closely resembles this the Wii Zapper in that one. So those are a thing. I mean I've collected the walkthroughs. So I have like quite a few of the walkthroughs. Oof. The Game Informers featuring the Resident Evil characters. I mean I have just tons of stuff. But the figures, this might be a lifelong goal, dream, whatever, but I actually do collect a lot of the figures. But so in the very beginning, I think this was released 1998, so 2 years after the first Resident Evil, they started making figures, and this is one of the five original. So this one's Jill with the web spinner, one of the infected huge spiders you find. But I have four out of the five. I just need the Tyrant to complete this series. So that kind of shows you those. But they've done tons and tons of figures. So the company Toy Biz originally did the figures in the beginning, and then what's the other? Then the company. NECA. I don't know if you pronounce it NECA or NECA, but they took over, and so they did two lines of the Toy Biz ones. So they did a Resident Evil 1, a Resident Evil 2, and then Toy Biz took over, or NECA took over. You can kind of see the logo there. But they took over and they made probably at least 100 different figures. But so I have the Regenerator from Resident Evil 4, the special like see-through one. Then they also did, there's also this company Palisades. They did a bunch of the figures. The Palisades figures are probably the rarest out of the figures. I'm not going to take it down. It's kind of mounted on the wall, but it's, I have the, Chris one, but it's kind of sun bleached. So if you leave these plastic things in the sun, they actually, they'll, turn yellow. So you don't want to leave your figures in the sun. At least the older stuff, does, but, so the Palisades are probably the rarest out of the figures, mostly being the Nemesis figure. I think that one's probably one of the rarest figures. And then I actually have three of the Play Arts figures. Play Arts does a lot of figures nowadays, so if you ever go to like a convention, or you can probably just find it online. Oh. And Play Arts makes... They make Final Fantasy, they make anime ones, they've redesigned like Catwoman and Batman and made figures of that, like, and superheroes, like, they do tons. And their figures are really high quality. Where Lowe's figures are you have the plastic box attached to the card. I guess it's a card. Where Lee's are the box ones. So I have the probably only Raccoon or Operation Raccoon City. I have the Lupo figure. Kind of show you that a little bit. So the Play Arts Lupo figure. I want to say I have all the Play Arts ones, but I'm probably wrong. No, I'm not even close. But Lee's ones are obviously a lot more than the other figures, but there's a lot less of them. I have the Resident Evil 5 Sheva one. And then the Resident Evil 6 Leon, which I think they only made Leon and Helena, but I could be wrong. So there's the Resident Evil 6 Leon. But I mean, they've done so many figures. So there's just tons of merchandise. I mean, you slap an umbrella logo on anything, you can probably sell it. as Resident Evil merchandise, but I like to keep the ones that are the official Capcom. They've actually done, like, back in the day of, like, Resident Evil 2, they have actually done clothing lines where it's, like, tactical gear and stuff like that. I never got my hands on that, but those were cool. I think that's all of that, but, kind of just tone it down. So I think I've explained almost basically everything about Resident Evil. So from everything I've explained, Resident Evil is, it's really about the characters and situations they're put through and kind of the environments you put in. It's, yeah, it's a zombie shooter, and every single game you shoot a gun. but it really, it's about the characters and what they go through and how they go through. And they have their staple characters. They're characters that are in every single game. Whether every game introduces more characters, but they still have like Jill, Chris, Leon, Claire. Those characters are in, we've fallen in love with those characters. And that's kind of where I'm worried. I really am. I'm worried about Resident Evil 7. I'm super hyped about it. I have a VR. I'm ready to play it. And I'm actually just about to play... I actually found out on my demo disc, there's something called The Kitchen, which I found out yesterday. Spoiler to me. It's the Resident Evil 7 VR demo, which I will be... probably recording probably tomorrow. but it's, I'm worried because from what I haven't done a lot of research on it. I played the original demo where you go through, you're first in that chair, and then you go through, and then you go through the VHS tape, and then you go through it again, and then you find yourself in that chair again. And you're in this house, and I've seen the trailer, where you're at that table with the people, and I don't want to spoil too much, but then again, I don't really know much, but I worry about it because I feel like it's such a different, it's too different from the other Resident Evils, and I haven't seen, usually they feature a character, but as far as I've seen, you are a nobody dealing with people that are just crazy. As far as I know, this isn't a Resident Evil game if they didn't slap the name on it. Now, obviously, I don't know anything about the game other than the trailer and the demo I played. My hopes might be rejuvenated after I play The Kitchen, though I really don't feel like it is, but yeah, very good at speaking. But I feel like, so going back, Silent Hill's always been a competitor with Resident Evil, and due to Kojima leaving, or basically Konami getting rid of Kojima, and then after PT was canceled, I feel like Capcom is really trying to take up on that, and their game really feels PT-ish, and it almost does a different take. I know that the demo felt like it was basically Blair Witch Project mixed with like found footage film. Like it's interesting what they're doing, but depending on what happens, I've been a fan of the series and I know what I'm talking about, and I really fear for what is in store for Resident Evil 7. I'm excited to play it. I'm excited to play a VR horror game that's fully fleshed out, completely, you know, the first party game, but we'll see what it holds. We'll see what the new movie holds. Both of them, we'll see what the new live action will hold. I'm really thinking it's gonna suck, but it's gonna be enjoyable. The animated film, I'm actually really high hopes for. It's probably gonna be pretty good. Resident Evil 7 is, we'll see. We'll see what happens. It feels very different. It feels very new, but we'll see. Cause, I don't know. I do have some theories on 7 from what I've seen. I do believe there is, obviously every game does new virus, so there might be almost a virus that affects the persona, or not persona, like your sanity. It might do something with that. Another thing I saw, or I never saw it in my playthrough, but I've seen videos of where there's a paranormal type entity, and Resident Evil has never had a paranormal thing in it. Everything is genetic, and obviously zombies don't exist, but almost realistic in a way. So it's all paranormal about that. I heard it's just, you know, they were just testing stuff out, but I hope they don't put any paranormal stuff in it, because it's never been about paranormal. But we'll see, because like I said, I love the Resident Evil series. It's, obviously, I play other games than Resident Evil, if you've seen my YouTube, but it's basically the core of my gaming career. I'm trying to do a career out of it, so either it's a career or a hobby, but my YouTube is going to be based off of horror games, Resident Evil in general, and then prop making. Games I like, but props. And I will be doing a Let's Play on every single Resident Evil game. I'll probably do multiple playthroughs of the same game but different console, kind of showing you differences. I'm putting those on. I know they're not old. That's why I know they're old. That's why I'm focusing on the new stuff for now. And then in between, I will be working on the old stuff. I will be starting with the original Resident Evil. But I mean, this is a series I fell in love with. It's such a good series. If you haven't played them, go and play them. Like, get yourself, thing is, you don't have to get the newest and greatest stuff. I mean, you can go and probably buy a PS1 for $20, get Resident Evil 1 for another $10-$20, and play one of the most influential games ever. And there's tons of those. I mean, it's not just Resident Evil, but Resident Evil definitely has those key moments, and especially Resident Evil 4. If you don't want to play the old ones, play Resident Evil 4. It's definitely worth it. But I mean, the series has cool bad guys. It's a lot of them that actually have really good multiplayer. Resident Evil 5 and 6 are completely multiplayer, and they require, you know, they require you to work together, and they're really great. I mean, all the games have really interesting stories. A lot of them you just can't wait till the end because it's, you know, you're just curious what happens. And a lot of the newer ones are doing, like, you know, like, oh god, they could actually die. And they take a different take. I mean, every game's different. Like, you can only shoot guys numbered certain ways, but they do it differently in every single one. So think that is it. So that's basically Resident Evil and everything you need to know about Resident Evil. There's nothing I didn't cover. I mean, I could go into the developers. The music, I'm going to be playing music through my entire spiel. I have been, so it's weird to talk about it now, even though it's not existing, even though I'm about to do it. But the music has, it makes half the series, I feel like. Like, there's characters and stories, but you can't have a good game without good music. And Resident Evil has had great music. Less so in the newer ones, because they've been more about the orchestrated, just intense, whatever, but the old games, oh my gosh, such a good composer. I mean, give that guy did it great. But yeah, that is basically it. Resident Evil in a nutshell. That's basically that. I felt like this should have been my first video on YouTube, but this is gonna be my stepping stone from here on out. This is a pinnacle point to my YouTube, because this is me. This is Resident Evil. This is what I've been doing for years and years and years. And yeah, so tell me in the comments below anything I've missed, anything you want to see in the future. Leave a like if you want to see those live action, or not live action. If you want to see those Let's Plays and get updated on them, please subscribe. And till next time, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Hi, lady. Hey, you look lovely. Please don't. That was my leg. Hey, you look gorgeous. I love your hair. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm coming. One second, you know? Okay. Oh. This way you don't fuck with me. Okay. We're cool. Yeah. You're not fucked. Yeah. You're in bad shape. Wanna come back and you're not safe? Okay. Yeah, want to come back? Yeah, there's someone behind me. I'm not turning now. I'm not doing it. Not doing it. Not doing it. Not doing it. Fuck no. Not doing it. Oh, a tree behind me. Just kill me. Yeah, you know you're there. you kill me already? Look! 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 Ah!